Today I lucked up by being a dumb shot and overloading on poop facilitators. Oh. My. God. This is ducking awful. So brief background. I've been on Adderall for a while, right? Well, the loveliest of side effects is that it makes your shut set up camp and just chill in your intestines. Technically you could say yesterday I ducked up, but it is today that I'm reaping the repercussions of my actions. So basically I hadn't pooped in almost a week. Bad news bears, I thought. So around 2 p.m. I decided to take a single extra strength laxative to kick down the doors and do some spring cleaning. No biggie. I do this sometimes. It usually results in a leisurely 30-minute session of poop just easily coming out of me like frozen yogurt. Naturally, later, I got hungry for dinner. Being the laziest ducking ham beast there is, I reached for something quick, disregarding my decision earlier. What I grabbed was my industrial size box of Fiber One bars, you know, the kind you can get at bulk stores, and could probably sustain a third world country for a day. So I sat myself down at my desk and resumed doing some college shut. I had my delicious Fiber One bars, of which I thought would be a good thing if I brought the entire box with me and my glass of chocolate milk. Now I'm lactose intolerant, but it's usually okay if I just drink a glass and be careful about what I eat the rest of the day. Being the dumb duck that I am, and not connecting all of these things, I lost track of all time and things, and before I knew it, I had downed 10 of those duckers and my full glass of milk. Ain't no thang, right? Wrong. By 10 p.m. the gurgle started. I just thought nothing of it and continued working. Then the farts came like the ducking Valkyrie. At first it was just one whisper thin fart every 15 minutes or so. Soon, it escalated to some sort of anal rapture. My hole was playing the 1812 overture in F minor. I swear to God, I think I ripped my sphincter. I went to bed around 5 a.m. and actually managed to fall asleep. At roughly 6 a.m. I was jostled awake by a fierce noise that I couldn't pinpoint the origin of. Then it happened. The farts had gotten worse and now sounded like Chewbacca deep-throating a burrito. It was terrible. My entire abdomen was cramping. Then the smell. It crawled through the air, something like a unique septic odor, like shit mixed with dead and decaying animals. This lasted for a few more hours. Every 2 minutes I'd cramp up, then release the tension in the form of severe anal rot. 10:30 comes around, and around that time I was going to take another rip, when I realized there was something sinister behind it. I'm not athletic, but I may as well been bred with Kenyans, because I ducking Usain bolted it to the toilet. Taking my place, the next thing I heard was a slight noise piercing the air, somewhat of a high-pitched squeak, then immediately followed by the most low and rumbling thunderous sound. Then the shut of a lifetime. The kind of shut that makes people stop believing in God. It was like I gave birth via my rectum. So now it's almost noon, and I'm sitting on the toilet typing this on my phone between anal hiccups from hell, since between that first gastric giant breaking the seal and now, it's been like my hole is just puking water. I'm hunched over from the pressure of gas on my insides. It feels like that thing from Alien is trying to claw its way out of my stomach and its screams are escaping by means of fart. I'm a dumb bitch. TLDR. If I die tonight, there's an 80% chance it's due to something shut related. Edit. The next day, OMFG, I'm in so much pain. It's like all my insides are in a vice. I feel like I'm trying to pass a ducking monolith. That was the most well-written and entertaining shutting story I've read in a while. 10 out of 10 would gag again. Today my brother ducked up by going to a stripe club. So, my brother isn't a Redditor, so I'm going to tell this story. We had a meeting out of town and 6 of us went. The meeting ended, and the beer and whiskey began to flow. It got a little later, and the hosts decided to call it a night, but we weren't about to give up a good time, so we decided the best thing to do was go to the only stripe club in this town. We go in, we pay our cover, and we grab a table a row away from the stage. Commence more drinking. At this point a few of the girls had started coming around and chatting. 6 bikers at a table seems to be a fairly lucrative venture for them. 3 guys get lap dances and there are 3 of us left at the table. I have my back to the stage, and I'm chatting with one of the dancers when the song ends and the next dancer is coming on stage. I can see her in the mirror in front of me. Impressive. My brother is directly across from me and facing the stage. The music starts. I look over at my brother and his face goes as pale as a hood at a white knight's rally, and he jumps up and bolts for the door. Directly, I turn and see the shapely ass end of the dancer as she's jumping off the stage and heading for the dressing room mid-song. My other brother and I jump up and run outside to figure out exactly what's going on. The brother that ran outside looks like he's having a panic attack. We talk him down and ask him what the hell is going on. He finally gets it out that the last girl on stage is his 19-year-old daughter that's attending the Christian university in town. Buzzes fade away, and with no real way to console him, I go back in and get the other brothers and explain what happened. We quietly climb on our bikes and ride home. Christmas should be very awkward at their house next week. TLDR, went to a stripe club with my brother where he saw his naked daughter flaunting her goodies for horny drunk men. Update, since so many asked for it, I called last night to see what happened. Thank you Reddit for making me have such an awkward conversation. So he called her the next day and was understandably upset. She of course brought up what so many of you have, the hypocrisy of him going to see naked women and then finding out his daughter danced there. She assured him that she's safe. Long talk ensued and ended with him not being okay with his daughter striping, but not being able to stop her from doing so either. He told me he'll never enter another stripe club. She'll be home next week for Christmas. I was invited over. We'll see. Today I ducked up by piercing someone's a hole. Alright, a bit of background. I've been a piercer at my local tattoo parlor for several years, and I have seen people do the simplest things like eyebrow piercings, cartilage piercings, etc. I've also seen people do the most bizarre things like duck crit ball piercings, and even anus piercings. I've only done two anus piercings in the 6 years I've worked there. This guy comes in and says he wants his a-hole pierced. I wanted to laugh, but I put my professional face on and told him prices and answered his questions. We get to the piercing room and I tell him to pull down his pants and get on all fours up on the table. Awkward already. Now I'm trying to get him to position his ass cheeks just right so I can get to his a-hole. I finally get him to spread his ass cheeks apart and I get my needle. I can tell the guy's getting really nervous so I said, "Don't tense up man, just relax, it's only gonna take a second. Just relax your anus, don't tense up, or it will only be worse." I have my face right up to this guy's anus, and I'm about to pierce him, and I say, "Okay, here we go." 2 seconds after I get the needle in, he blasts shut all over my face. I start screaming like a mother ducker trying to wipe shut off my face, and he starts trying to stand up. But the needle is still in his ass, and he screams bloody ducking murder. My boss runs in to find me wiping shut off my face, and this poor duck screaming and crying with his pants down. After I got cleaned up, and we got the needle out his ass, I said, "Why did you shut on me?" He just stood there obviously embarrassed, and he says, "You said to relax my anus. I'm so sorry. I will never pierce an anus ever again." Why would you want your anus pierced? That would just be a pain in the ass every time you sat down. Today I learned ass piercing is a thing. Today I learned people will do crazy shit for money. Sometimes people will pay to experience what happened to OP. Today I ducked up by having anal sass for the first and probably last time. So this girl I had seen once the previous weekend asked if she could come over. I said okay. We ended up drinking some, then went out to dance. We got very drunk and slept together when we came home. We did all sorts of crazy stuff and then we came to a mutual understanding to have anal sass. I had always thought of it as a bit forbidden and exciting and was feeling nervous for it. We went slow at first and it felt good, not as good as I thought though, and then harder after a while. She said it felt good, so we kept going. However, when I pulled out, the shut hit the fan. Weird suction in her ass made the contents fly out and cover my sheets and some of my walls. I was panicking, picking up the pieces and threw them in the toilet. When I came back in, she had started bleeding as well. I asked her if we need to go to the hospital. She was all quiet, said it was okay, and then just left. I was standing naked in my room, smelly condom on my dick, blood and shut on my sheets. Now, 12 hours later, I've thrown away the sheets, cleaned my walls, but my room smells really bad. And I never wanna do anal again. TLDR, had anal sass, had to clean up girl's shirt, room smells like it, anal sass ruined, edit, cleared the air with said girl, apparently it was period blood, but she didn't notice that, because of drunkenness darkness anal vacuum shock. So, I didn't hurt her at least. Lube, you dense motherducker. Lube, you think you ducked up, imagine how she feels.